Good morning, children. Welcome to the part 4, and this is the last part of the chapter Meaning, Objectives and Terminology of Accounting. Now in this chapter we are going to start and do the most important part of this chapter, which is the classification of accounts. Now one very important point in this chapter, which provides the basis of your accounting, is the classification of accounts. That means the types of accounts. As you can see in the diagram or in the flow chart, there are three main types of accounts. Those are personal account, real account and nominal account. So there are three types of accounts: personal, real and nominal. Personal account can further be divided into three parts: personal natural, personal artificial and personal representative. So first of all, let us discuss each account and its sub-classification in detail. So personal account, as the name suggests, something to do with the person or like that. So as we can see, there are three types of accounts: personal account, real account and nominal account. And we can see that personal account is further classified into personal natural, personal artificial and personal representative. Now, personal natural basically consists of all the human beings. Me, you, your principal, your mother, your father, your sister, all the human beings. If we ask, for example, Mr. Rahul is which account? Mr. Rahul is a human being, so that will be considered as a personal natural. If I ask you, your principal sir is which account? Again, he is a human being, so personal natural. So all the human beings comes under personal natural. Then personal artificial. Personal artificial includes all those institutions, companies, organizations, universities, business houses, banks, etc., which are not actually human beings, but they are working like human beings. They are not the actual human beings, but they are working like human beings. For example, when you go to submit your fees in your school with your fee book, what happens? You pay the fee, the accountant there signs on the fee receipt. And also he puts the stamp, the seal of the school also. Without the seal, that fee book is just not valid. So if we consider what is that stamp or what is that seal for the school, it is kind of a signature of the school. And without that seal, no document of the school will be binding on anyone. Unless and until the seal of the school is put up, no document will be binding, or the school will not be responsible for any of the documents. So can we say in simple words that the seal there is kind of a sign of the school? In the similar fashion, whenever you go to bank, you deposit some money, you fill in the paying slip, the banker there or the person who is depositing your money, he puts the stamp of the bank. Without the stamp of the bank, the paying slip will not be of any use. It will not be valid. The money will not be deposited into your account. So that means that seal is kind of a signature for the bank. Then whenever you deposit the money, you do put the branch name of the bank. So that means you are entering into the contract with the bank. Or if you are purchasing the shares of a company, you write the name of the company because you are contracting or you are dealing with that particular company. So if we, summarize that the companies, the organization, the schools, the colleges, they are working like human beings. They are entering into contact. They are entering into contact. They are coming into contact and they are entering into contract also. They are signing the documents just like human beings, but they are not the human beings. So they will be regarded as an artificial person. So therefore, they will be categorized under personal artificial account. For example, if I ask you, your school EHS, Ethel Higginbottom School and College, is which account? So it will be personal, artificial. Bank of Baroda, Bank of India, Girls High School, Boys High School, Reliance Industries Limited, Tata Industries, then your Ames Hospital, anything, SRN, all these institutions, etc. Then Allahabad University, Schwartz, all these are personal artificial account. Then representative, basically personal representative account includes all those items which represent your assets and your liabilities. You are very much familiar with the word assets and liabilities because we have already discussed these two words in the basic terminology chapter. So personal representative accounts includes all those items which represent your assets and your liabilities. So for example, all those expenses which are yet to be paid means outstanding expenses, all those expenses which you were supposed to pay but you have not paid till date, that is outstanding. So that represents your liability that you have to pay it. So that will be considered as personal representative. For example, if you are living in a rented house and if you have to pay the rent of 6 months but you have paid only for 5 months, so the 1 month rent which you have not paid, that will be considered as outstanding expense and that is a liability of yours. That means you are liable to pay that 1 month outstanding rent. Then it can also include outstanding income. For example, you have performed your work for somebody and in return you have to receive certain amount of income which you have not received. You have done your work, you have rendered your service, but you have not yet received the payment. So in that case, that will be outstanding income, that will represent your asset because you have performed the work but you have not received the payment. For example, if you have given a certain amount of loan to somebody, you have given the loan, that means you will be receiving the interest. So suppose if you have received the interest for 10 months but remaining 2 months you have not received, you have given the loan already, time has already passed but you have not received the interest for 2 months. So that outstanding interest for 2 months will be an outstanding income for you, or we can say accrued income for you. So that will represent your asset. Similarly, prepaid expenses. There can be expenses which are prepaid. That means you have paid in advance. So if you are living in a rented house, again I am taking the same example. If you are living in a rented house and if you have paid the rent in advance for 4 months. So since the 4 months are yet to come, but you have already paid the rent in advance. So the rent paid in advance of those 4 months which are yet to come, the services are yet to be taken, that will be considered as prepaid expenses and that will represent your asset because you have already made the payment for that and you just have to receive the services. On the other hand, there can be pre-received income. That means there can be income which you have received in advance. So that will be considered as a liability for you. That will represent a liability for you. For example, if you are to sell some good to somebody and you have received the payment for the good in advance, so that will be considered as pre-received. Or for example, I will again take the example of the loan given. If you have given the loan to somebody and you have received the interest for the loan in advance for 2 months, so the interest received in advance for 2 months will represent your liability because the time has yet not come, the interest has yet not fallen due, but you have received in advance. So these four expenses and income: outstanding expenses, prepaid expenses, outstanding income, pre-received income. These four items represents your assets and your liabilities. They are representing it and therefore they will be a part of personal representative account. Then we have discussed the term bank overdraft in the BRS chapter and also while discussing the current liabilities. So bank overdraft also represents your liability. Why? Because bank overdraft is what? It is just a negative bank balance. Bank overdraft shows the amount in excess which you have withdrawn from your bank account more than your deposit. So that excess money which you have withdrawn is kind of a short-term loan. It represents your liability towards the bank. So again, it will be a part of personal representative account. Then we have discussed one term in the basic terms chapter, that is capital. What is capital? We have discussed that capital is the amount invested by the proprietor in the business. The money which the proprietor or the owner or the businessman has invested in business is known as capital. So, and we have also discussed the chapter of concepts, whereby we have discussed that business and businessman are not the same, and therefore this capital invested by the businessman is not regarded as the money of the business. It is treated as a kind of a loan advance by the proprietor to the business. This money is required to be returned to the owner. So therefore, capital also represents a liability, and therefore capital will also be a part of personal representative account. So these are the types of personal account: natural, artificial and representative. Then the second type of account is real account. Real account mainly deals with your assets, and your assets can be tangible or intangible. We have already discussed what are tangible assets and what are intangible assets while discussing the basic terminology chapter. But just for revision sake, tangible assets include all those assets which can be seen and touched. For example, land, building, machinery, tools, furniture, etc. So these will be considered as real tangible account. And intangible assets means all those assets which cannot be seen or touched, but they can only be felt. Their benefits can only be felt. For example, goodwill, patents, copyrights and trademark. So these four are the intangible assets, and they will come under real account. So if I ask you that furniture is which account, so the answer will be furniture is a real tangible account. Then land is which account? Real tangible. Tools is which account? Real tangible. Livestock means animals. If any business is dealing in animals or is utilizing animals, then animal is known as livestock. The stock of animals is known as livestock because they have life in it. So that will also be a part of real tangible. Equipments, real tangible. Goodwill, real intangible, because they cannot be seen or touched. Patents, real intangible. Copyrights, real intangible. Trademarks, real intangible, etc. And what are basically, what is goodwill? Goodwill is the reputation or image of the business measured in monetary terms. What is copyright? Whenever any artistic work is done, lyrics or any book has been written or anything, so the author of the book or the basically the writer of the lyrics or the lyricist, they get their work copyrighted. That means without their permission, nobody can copy it. Then trademark is somewhat like copyrights, but trademark is related to the goods. Many business houses, they get their logos, their marks, their brand image, their font size, their brand color, etc. trademarked or registered, so that nobody can copy it without their permission. For example, the logo of Pepsi is a trademark. It cannot be copied without the permission of the PepsiCo India Holding Private Limited. Then the patents. When any invention or discovery is done, so the inventor has the right, he can get it patented, so that again nobody can copy it without his permission. So these are basically intellectual property rights. So these come under real intangible assets. Then nominal account. Nominal account basically deals with the expenses, incomes, losses and gains. So nominal account includes expenses and losses. For example, purchases, कमीशन पेड, सैलरी पेड, रेंट पेड, वेजेस पेड, इंटरेस्ट पेड, डिविडेंड पेड, लाइटिंग एक्सपेंसेस पेड, कैरिज एक्सपेंसेस पेड एक्सेट्रा. And it also includes the losses. For example, bad debts. We have discussed the meaning of bad debt, that it is the amount which could not be recovered from the debtors. So nominal account also includes losses such as bad debts, loss on sale of goods, loss on sale of machinery, loss on sale of investments, etc. Discount allowed, depreciation, etc. Then it also includes incomes and gains. Incomes like commission received, sales, interest received, then your discount received, rent received, etc. And gains, for example, profit on sale of goods, profit on sale of investments, profit on sale of assets, etc. So these are three types of accounts. Personal account, which can further be divided into natural, artificial and representative. Real account, which can be further divided into tangible and intangible, and nominal account, which can further be divided into expenses and losses, incomes and gains. Now note, when any word as a prefix or a suffix, prefix means any word is attached before some word, and suffix means when any word is attached after some word, is added to the nominal account, very important. Those items which comes under nominal account, for example, commission, rent, interest, dividend, etc. When any word as a prefix or suffix is added to the nominal account, means all those items which comes under nominal account, if any word is added before that word of nominal account or after that word, then it becomes a personal account. For example, if the word outstanding is added before or prefixed to rent, outstanding rent. Rent is a nominal account, but if outstanding word is added, outstanding rent, then it becomes a personal account. And personal which account? Personal representative account. Then if again rent is a nominal account, but if any other word is attached to it before, prepaid rent, then prepaid rent becomes your personal representative account. So for example, rent account is a nominal account, but outstanding rent or prepaid rent account is a personal account. And personal which account? Personal representative account. Similarly, commission account is a nominal account, but commission received in advance. So received in advance is suffixed, has been added after the word commission. So that becomes a personal account, again personal representative account. So for example, interest is a nominal account, but prepaid interest, then it will become a personal representative account. Then again, interest is a nominal account, but interest received in advance will become a personal representative account. Now, rules of debit and credit, very important. These are known as golden rules of accounting. Different account has different golden rule, which you need to remember by heart throughout, because these will be very helpful in your practical chapters, and these type of questions are very important. These may be asked for your vivas as well when you reach class 12. So the golden rules of accounting for personal account is, we will debit the receiver and we will credit the giver. Just like we speak Hindi, English, Marathi, Gujarati, Urdu, Telugu, etc. In the similar fashion, debit and credit is the language of accounts. So as we have done already in the meaning of double entry system, that every transaction has two aspects. One is to be debited and the other is to be credited. So what is to be debited and what is to be credited? That depends on these golden rules, because while solving the questions, while determining whether something has to be debited or something has to be credited, first of all, we have to analyze whether that particular item is a part of personal account or real account or nominal account. First of all, we have to identify that. And after identifying that, we have to first of all basically apply or identify the name of the account or the category of account to which it belongs, and then we have to apply the golden rule. So if any item comes under personal account, for example, Ram is a personal account, So in that case, we have to apply the rule debit the receiver and credit the giver. We will debit the receiver and we will credit the giver. Then real account, the golden rule is debit what comes in and credit what goes out. And nominal account, the rule is debit all expenses and losses and credit all incomes and gains. So personal account, the rule is debit the receiver and credit the giver. Real account, debit what comes in and credit what goes out. And nominal account, debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. So these are the golden rules of accounting which you need to remember by heart. Then points to remember. Number one, all assets, these are basically, these are the rules in addition to the golden rules which will be helping you in solving the practical problems in different chapters. So point number one, all assets, expenses and losses have a debit balance. If I ask you, asset carries which balance? You remember that asset is a part of real account. So real account says debit what comes in and credit what goes out. So if the asset is coming in, it will be debited. If the asset is going out, it will be credited. Very simple. But if I ask you, what is the general balance of asset? I never told you whether it is coming in or going out. In that case, this rule number one will apply, that all assets, expenses and losses have a debit balance. Similarly, point number two, all liabilities, incomes and gains have a credit balance. So all assets, expenses and losses have a debit balance, and all liabilities, incomes and gains have a credit balance. Then rule number three, if there is an increase in the balance of asset, it is debited. On the contrary, if there is a decrease in the balance of assets, it is credited. So remember the rule number one, that all assets have a debit balance. So if the value of asset increases, we will debit it more. But if the value of asset decreases, we will do the opposite part. That means it will be credited. On the other hand, point number four, if there is an increase in the balance of liabilities, it is credited. On the contrary, if there is a decrease in the balance of liabilities, it is debited. That means liabilities have a credit balance, that we have learnt in point number two here. So if the value of liabilities increases, we will credit it. But if the value of liabilities decreases, we will do the opposite part, that is we will debit it. So these are points which you need to remember, the golden rules and these points or rules, additional rules, so as to solve the practical problems which we'll be discussing in the upcoming videos. So I hope the topics discussed in this video is clear to you children. Now this is the assignment based on this part. You have to answer the following questions in your register. Question number one, you have to draw a chart to show the classification of accounts. So for this question, you can make the chart which is given in this video. You can take the help from this video or the PDF notes, and you will make that chart as an answer to this question. The chart will be this one. You can prepare this chart as an answer to this question. Question number two, you have to explain the types of accounts. So in this, you will be explaining the personal account and its types, the real account and its types, and nominal account and its types. So in this you will explain personal account, that these are accounts related to an individual, firm, company, institution. Then you will explain its subtypes, personal account which includes the human beings such as Ram, Shyam, etc. Artificial personal account, whereby you will explain that these accounts do not have physical existence as human beings, but they work as personal accounts, for example, firm, institution, universities, etc. And then you will explain the representative personal account, where an account represents a particular person or group of persons. It is known as representative personal accounts. It includes outstanding incomes, pre-received incomes, outstanding expenses, prepaid expenses. Then you will explain the real accounts, that those accounts or the accounts of all those things whose value can be measured in terms of money, which are the properties of the business, are termed as real accounts. For example, cash account, furniture account, goodwill account, etc. And then you will explain its further types, that is tangible account. It includes all those assets which can be touched and seen. For example, land, building, etc. Then you will explain its another subtype, which is intangible asset, or basically intangible real account, where we include all those assets which cannot be seen or touched but can only be felt. For example, goodwill, patents, etc. And then you will explain the nominal accounts, that these accounts include the accounts of all expenses, losses, incomes and gains. For example, discount paid, rent received, discount received, commission received, etc. So all the types of accounts have been explained in detail in your PDF notes. Then question number 3, you have to state the golden rules of accounting in case of personal account. So the golden rule in case of personal account is debit the receiver and credit the giver. Real account, the golden rule is debit what comes in and credit what goes out. And nominal account, the rule is debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. Then question number 4, you have to fill in the given blanks. All assets, expenses and losses have a debit balance, that we have discussed in points to remember. Then B1, all liabilities, incomes and gains have a credit balance. This also we have discussed. Then point number C, if there is an increase in the balance of assets, it is debited. Means jo bhi iska balance hai, we'll do that. On the contrary, if there is a decrease in the balance of assets, it is credited. Then last one, if there is an increase in the balance of liabilities, it is credited. On the contrary, if there is a decrease in the balance of liabilities, it is debited. So I hope the topics discussed in this video is clear to you children. Just go through the video once again, revise whatever we have done till now, revise all the 4 parts, because this chapter is very, very important when you start with the practical question, which we will start from the upcoming video. So go through all the parts, revise all the work, complete all the written work, and also learn all the question and answers, children. And especially the types, the golden rules of accounting, because in the upcoming videos we will be starting with the practical chapters. Thank you, children. Take care.